And now, the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
What you gotta, what you gotta do? You got to tell him. Just like that. Yeah, Lou? Yeah. Are we rolling? It's the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big J. Oakerson, Dan Soder.
That's a funky one.
Funky what?
A breath. A weird breath. Is this not?
Oh, there we are, Lou.
Shit's got the funk.
I'll just tell you this. What I like about Lou is he lets us listen to the song until he's had enough, and then I like that he clicks on the mic, and we're like, okay, we got to get in line for school.
All right.
Okay, fine. It's time to go to work. All right, Christine, bringing in the big... We're up in the office for this, for the Lost Tapes. This is a Bonfire Lost Tapes Thursday, meaning it's Frankenstein.
We're in the... full disclosure, we're in the office. And our old friend, Merkface, is floating around. And Merkface told me he's been enjoying the roof of his building. And I'm trying to warn him, I don't know if you're allowed on those roofs, and you might get in trouble. We got caught pretty bad on my roof. And weren't fucking or anything. But, I mean, we got caught, like, we got so used to going up there and being like, we're never going to get in trouble for this, that we brought, at one point, we brought up, like, a Beats pill and wine and all kind of, and it's just like... It will go haywire.
Who got mad at you for being up there?
Super. Came up with a flashlight.
Do you have a super in your building?
No.
Oh. Me neither.
I just have the...
Oh, that's big then.
The laundromat, they close at like 9.
Uh-huh.
So the only ones who would rat us out would be the other neighbors.
Yeah, but a lot of windows around you?
None.
Oh, well then there's no point anyway.
Oh, so yours just peeping Tom?
Yeah.
You don't like views? Views are different than the views that Andy was talking about.
Well, no. I like a good view. I like a good view.
Yeah. But then you also want to see a girl undressed in the bathroom.
Right. Or a dude beat off to completion. I've seen both these things.
You've watched a man go from beating off to finished?
From soft to worked up to finished. And
is it as closest to being in a human zoo and watching like an experiment happen?
Yeah, it was sort of like that.
Because psychologically, that's got to be fascinating.
And I told you, I was very... the reason I hung in there... No attraction to it.
Well, you liked his pace?
No,
there you go. This guy's got a rhythm going.
I was
watching a drum solo.
I was locked in to see. I'm like, how does this guy come when no one's there? What's he doing?
Oh,
what's his cleanup method?
Does
what's
he cap? Does he spray? Was he?
He puts paper towels on his chest,
like
his
violin
left shoulder
player.
Chest, yes.
Like the way violin players lay cloths on their shoulder.
And beats into his fucking.
Oh, yeah.
Shoulder, basically.
We call that a Juilliard. When you beat up, when you go, I'd like to play my instrument, the one that I know the best.
I think about the 10-gauge kickback.
Yeah. Kapow! I got to put something on your shoulder or else that'll dislodge it. Can't go walking around.
Put some burlap on there. So I'm just saying, they'll get so comfy. But if it's all that, the view is great, though.
Yeah, nice Midtown Manhattan, Triborough Bridge.
Do you have
That's beautiful. Are you down on 24th Avenue?
Yeah.
I know exactly where you are. That's a beautiful view.
Yeah.
Do you have is there a wall like around it? Around the thing.
Build that wall! No, you guys aren't doing that? Oh, damn it.
Do you know what I'm saying? Is there like a ledge? Or
yes.
Is it just straight death if you walk off?
There's a sizable border.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Perfect.
And it's silver bottom, so I don't think it's going to get too hot. You know, it's like that silver roof paint.
I have the white roof paint, and that can get pretty hot, but it's not as bad as like the black tar ones that you see in some of the old city buildings.
Oh,
where you're like,
God.
Are you trying to kill people up here?
Your feet melt into it.
Yeah. Dude, the best one was I was at a 4th of July barbecue up on this rooftop, down actually by your guys' apartment. I want to say it was like 7th and 1st up on this roof, and I was looking over. I was drinking at the time. And
back
I was
there, Dan. What were you wearing?
I was wearing
parachute pants.
I was wearing some cargo shorts.
Yes. I guess the idea was like it's way more throwback than it actually is. Goes,
a zoot suit.
I'm wearing a Thriller jacket.
Yeah, I am in some acid wash ripped jeans, a tight I'm in the Eddie Murphy leather suit,
the bandana around the neck like Eddie Van Halen.
Yeah. 1973. I have some really awesome bell bottoms and a tight sequin shirt on. But I was throwing my keys down to the people like my. It was my friend's apartment. My friend was like, drop the keys down to our other friend.
Yeah.
So I went to the edge of the roof, and it was like a, it was a split party where it was half my friend Janice and all of our friends, and then half this other girl who had like a beer pong table that we were using. So the parties got mishmash. But then the lady from that party, as I'm about to drop the keys over the side, she goes, get away from the edge. And I'm like, yeah, don't yell at someone that's sitting on the edge of a building. Yeah. That is like,
what are you doing over there? And it had no border?
No, it didn't. It was just down. It was just
you
like
a full barbecue on a.
Oh, it was back. It was far back from the
still
roof.
Still, though.
Yeah, but there was no border. It was just straight, like, ledge.
And you walked to the edge and dropped
the
keys?
No, I laid over. I was laying down.
Yeah,
I wasn't standing
no way.
Up.
I would.
No, I crawled up.
My
there.
Legs would start actually doing that weird thing. Yeah. You ever get that when your body doesn't agree with your head? Going to try something?
No, no, no. Dude, when I went skydiving. There's a moment where I was like, and the guy's like, all right, he was on my back. It was one of the ones where I was tied to his front, and he's like, move forward, and my body, I was like, my body won't move. Because they were like about to open the plane door, and he's like, move forward, and you're like, all right. And then you're watching people jump out, and he's like, put your legs over the side, and my legs are like, fuck you. We're not going over the side of a plane. Because you hang your legs off like a bridge or something, but when it's a plane and you can feel it, like the wind moving your legs, and then he's like, all right, you ready? Look back.
You're moving at the speed of airplane.
Yeah, you're like, this is so fast and cold. And I had, that was the summer of linen, so I was rocking the linen shorts.
You skydove in linen shorts?
Goddamn right I did. There's parachute shorts.
They don't make you wear like a thing?
Oh, you have a harness on, so like my pants were kept down, but I wore the linen shorts like in the harness.
What a jag.
Oh, man, it was great.
I mean, that wind just beating your shit around, huh?
Yeah, well, my dick was pressed. Here's what happened. They do, like, a harness right on the inside of your hips, and he tightened it so much that it kind of ruined the fun of the jump. Because when he pulled the chute, it was like, it just fucking got ripped up by my hip, where I was like, And the whole time I was going down, he's like, isn't it beautiful? And I'm like,
You're just trying to fucking get your thighs not being ripped.
Oh yeah, then you when I got down, I mean I was bruised on my thigh for like a good week after that, but it was fun. When you roll out of the plane, that's
fun.
The best.
Was it the most amazing experience of your life ever?
It was a lot of fun. I fucking
but
loved
not
it.
The most amazing experience of your life. I mean,
here's the most amazing experience.
I just the fact you survived it to me. I don't think I can do it. My heart says I'd like to do it.
We should do it.
I can't do it, Long Island.
Dude, I'm telling you.
Also, being fat, I'm always like, I'll be the guy that I'm going to tangle up in the wires. Everyone's going to laugh. I'm going to die. It's going to, when you start coming down and it goes from like parachuting like that, where you're just like spinning wildly, connected to a bunch of strings like a puppet.
I'm on the ground with my instructor who's like, oh God, it's happening. Guys, we got an Operation Hippo. Hippo loose. This guy's spinning out of control.
The fucking visual of me just like everyone else is coming down nice and smooth with their little fucking hand things aiming themselves and I'm in a crazy all that's left of my parachute is like a little tiny part of it that's like the only reason I'm not falling faster and I'm just being circled
and it's
around
making that vicious whipping sound where it's like
yeah
no
yeah I'm out of control. I may be passed out already. Is he out? God damn it, he's out! Someone, see if you can aim towards him.
The thought of your head just hanging, and you're in the harness.
Putting the pistol, just getting whipped a mile a minute.
And I'm down there with some fucking Argentinian jumper. He's like, oh no, your friend is in very big trouble.
You're just yelling, Jay.
Jay!
As a guy, like in a baby Bjorn. you're an adult baby yelling, Jay.
I wish you had the Top Gun music. When Goose dies, when he goes in the water, you're like, Jay, no!
Yeah, and then you see me fucking like that soft land. It finally uncoils, and my dead body just falls into the ocean.
You just crumple in.
Yes. And I get covered by the big parachute.
You would love
it. Parachute.
It's fun. If you do it, it's fun. It's crazy to roll.
The fact that you're saying it's not wasn't the most amazing experience of your life, that says I won't do it.
But that's a subjective question. What's the most amazing experience of your life? Like, for me,
I can't think of anything more than flying out of an airplane, jumping out of an airplane and living to tell the story.
But living to tell a story is like, that's not that amazing to me because they do it. Like, the guy I was talking to, I was like, how many jumps did you do today? He's like, about 7, 8. And you're like, oh, you just jump all the time. Jump! He wakes up in the morning. Jump! He had a great stepdad name, too. It was Rich.
Oh,
so I was on Rich's.
You feel safe with a guy named Rich.
And he's like, Rich, how you doing? He's like, all right, pretty good. And he was just that no-nonsense. He wasn't. He was like hard to impress. Where he goes, all right, here's what's going to happen. Plane's going to come back down. Why don't we get you in the harness and We're going to go up there. And I'm like, you know how we are. You try to make people laugh when you're nervous. So I'm like trying to be funny. He goes, yeah, I'm just going to need to get you in the plane. And I'm like, oh, God damn it. That military energy doesn't
work.
Like,
hey, when you're down there working with my grundle and those straps, you know.
Yeah,
keep
you go.
Keep it light, huh?
You go, hey,
he's
Rich.
Like, I don't know, what's a grundle?
Yeah. Hey, Rich, don't knock my bag around. He goes, I don't. All right, we got to get in the plane.
You mean like your shoot?
All right. I just jump. I do all my thinking in the air.
I don't really fraternize.
So I'm going to need you to shut the hell up.
That kind of sucks to have like a very serious guy breathing on the back of your neck coming down. He's like, it's pretty heavy.
Beautiful, isn't it? I can tell you lack intimacy. You won't lean your head back. Okay. Yeah, no, I'm having fun.
Those mountains. Majestic.
Don't you love how the water meets the land? Crazy, this is all going to be gone in 50 years.
You're like, what? Are you a conspiracy theorist, too?
This would be so much less gay if you were abroad.
Yeah. God, I wish you had a fat butt and a pussy.
Well, you know what they say. Everything's a pussy at 35,000
feet. Yeah. You ever been threatened anally up in the air? Because I pulled this plug and you're goner.
Didn't a couple fuck while skydiving?
No.
I'm pretty sure.
Christine, can you please Google that? A couple fucked skydiving?
Yeah, I think so.
Man, if I was afraid about pulling down too far to fuck on the ground, dude, you pull out too far and come in on that, you're just going to be just destroyed.
If my chute goes up and it deploys perfectly, I'll fuck that.
Oh, that's a definite get her pregnant. If you're fucking before you pull the chute, then you pull it, you go, spunk, right as you're shooting. Oh, no, Jay, shoot!
I think he's still inside of her. He's whipping around. Yeah, it's that guy Voodoo.
Wait, the guy's name's Voodoo and he fucks in the
you've
air?
I've seen him in porn.
Dude, I can barely get a boner when I know my roommate's in the other room.
Let alone a pilot.
Yeah. Oh, he's doing it in the plane.
No. I think they jump. Fuck it. I'm pretty sure. I mean, this is in the plane biz. This is getting worked up.
What's funny
is... You don't want to try to work up a boner.
Hold on. Go back. What's funny is he's mixing being a skydiving instructor with porn, where there really is no nonsense in skydiving instruction. So she's like, yeah, fuck me. And he's like, move your hand. Just move your hand down here. I can't have you.
Oh, what are you censoring this for us, Christine?
Yeah. Oh, he really is fucking her.
He's got a big piece, too, so...
Oh, what? That's incredible. She has the best airport story. She goes, I'm in fact at 35,000 feet. How do you want it, baby? You can't give it to me unless you earn your skydiving license.
Yeah, they fucked the whole way down.
The whole way down.
I think he's just in her. I mean, maybe unless you think the wind.
I mean, she's got to dry up.
What if she coughs and his dick does that, where it comes out and goes like... You ever get that one?
Oh, yeah.
The come out when it's...
Oh, yeah.
It was like, positionally wrong.
Yep. And it just pops out. But he doesn't finish.
Well, who am I to say? I don't know.
I mean, his face is like...
At the end, she gets
his
out.
Face
is... What if they land and she blows the creep by?
Yeah. She's like... She goes, that's up from 35,000 feet. We call that a landing. Can you screen grab his face from before where he was like... He had such porn face in the air, it's so silly.
Look at him, he's pumping.
Yeah, he's like, eh, yeah. I mean...
Oh, this is more romantic.
Yeah, this is.
How she's playing with her own nips in the air is kind of funny. I mean...
Someone's out in their backyard and they go, are those two skydive fucking?
Move forward a little bit. God, it's a long video.
Yeah, I gotta jerk off. This is for everyone that loved... Fuck, what was that Charlie Sheen movie? I just watched Maximum Velocity. Isn't that
you just watched it again?
Well, we watched it before we went skydiving.
Oh, really?
We watched all skydiving movies. So we watched...
Who'd you go with?
My buddies Josh and Zach. They bought it for my birthday. It was 2 years ago.
Yeah. No, I remember when you did
it. Yeah, it was right before the bonfire started.
I would do it if I... One, if that guy was fucking me.
If I had a dick in my butt.
Or two, that you told me it was the most amazing experience.
But the most amazing experience.
What's
of my
the most
life?
Amazing experience of your life? Amazing.
I mean, for me, it's comedy related. Probably, like, probably doing an hour special was like pretty amazing. Like, that's like the most amazing moment in my life where I'm like, oh shit, I worked at this and I get to do this.
Yeah, we're talking about different kinds of amazing. I'm saying like the most exhilarating, like holy shit, feeling.
Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt, skydiving. I mean, I love roller coasters.
Emotionally, I might say.
But you said, like, the most incredible experience of your life. That, to me, that doesn't mean, if you were like, is that the most adrenaline, the craziest shit you've ever done? 1,000%. You roll out, man. You roll out of that plane, and you're fucking falling. You're just like,
falling to the earth.
Yeah, and it's crazy. And it's cold as shit. And then I did it in the summer, so you felt
to
get warm.
Did you do flips with you and shit?
We just went around, like, a bunch.
Really?
I don't know if I don't remember doing flips. We just went around a bunch. Like,
oh, that would have been crazy.
Oh, wow. Are they still going?
Yeah, they're parachute deployed. She's coming.
Hey. I love that's the video, like the photos they give you after you skydive. They go, here where you were coming, right when your chute came out.
I'll tell you what I'm impressed by is how well Katy Perry's music lines up with
skydive fucking. I think that's actually her process. I heard her and John Mayer have to jump out of a plane and bang, and then she writes a song. She goes, it came to me.
It came. Now, here's the thing I will say. I don't know if there's any penetration for real. Whole thing might have been acted out.
Oh.
That doesn't look dick to puss to me.
You're saying it looks softcore.
Oh, my God. Plus, you don't want to land with your dick in your girl's butt. Oh, God.
Oh, he wasn't in her.
You don't think?
By the way, that girl is going to be definitely addicted to methamphetamines after that. You're getting fucked in the sky, and you're not going to go back.
Ago.
You're not going to start using needle drugs after you've been...
I'm saying this is years ago. I'm sure she's fucking dead or methed out by now.
Yeah.
But that was the first day. That was the first day of the rest of her life.
Yeah.
Meth addiction.
Everyone has to try
Everyone has to try it.
I know a lot of people that should not try it.
Me.
We do them in the air. We do them crazy.
They're never cool dudes, are they, male porn stars?
No, I don't think they can be.
They're never, ever cool dudes. Watch an interview with any male porn star, and you're going to fucking hate them. I wouldn't mind jumping into this topic.
Okay.
But... Because we're going to have two more segments.
Yeah. This is for
the
lost
tapes. We can dig into this more.
Yeah.
But right now, I bet we want to have a good laugh. Yeah. You can look up male porn star interviews.
Do you think they're all going to be like Dirk Diggler and Boogie Nights where he's like,
nope, I think
Jack lets me direct my own sets.
Yeah. There's going to be some of that. But there's going to be, it's going to be all kinds. It's going to be six different variations on every person you would hate immediately.
Because they get laid for a living.
It's just something. Look up like a Nick Manning or something like that. Or
no, those are like those gigolo guys, right?
Nick Manning, or Evan Stone, or any. I guarantee. If you look at the old ones, like the Jamie Gillises of the 80s, dude, they're flat out skeevy. They look gross. They fucking.
Well, I wake up in a pool of oil. Usually, it's like some sort of olive oil or fucking juice. I've slept in there all night. And I
think there could be a lot of this story. He's like.
Oh, yeah. I remember her. I fucked her in a van in Malibu. Yeah, she loved it.
Yeah,
because they're the opposite of us.
Yeah, look up like a Randy West interview or any of those guys. If you look up a Jamie Gillis, J-A-M-I-E.
I'm telling you.
G-I-L-L-I-S.
Fucking these robot guys.
I mean, you'll see. I mean, he's crust. Harry Reams.
Oh yeah.
Anybody, but even the guys of today, like the muscly dudes of today, they're just jag offs, dude.
Yeah. Well, because it's what you put your body into. It's like the same way that like a lot of those Instagram hoes are just fucking vapid idiots. It's because their only work is like working out, looking awesome, and then having like fit tummy tea where they're like buy it, and they show a little bit of tit. Oh, here it is.
Oh yeah.
He looks like a fucking jazz musician.
I wish you could find an interview with him younger.
So she had a little swagger. She doesn't have that kind of a, sweet little girly, victim.
Well, this is Jamie Gillis as an older man, and it really is like he's got that energy of like, hey, why don't we go in this other room and take off our pants?
Oh, yeah. Look, he's drinking a nice gin.
He goes, I remember when we made it. Right there on the beach, there were big crew.
It
was from
1983. Here we go.
How long have you two been going together in the business?
She's been my steady date for the last few months. I don't let her out of my sight, unless she's going to do an interview, in which case
Here's the thing, in the 80s, these porn stars look like dudes that you worked with. That guy's got office face.
Oh, dude, he's
Jamie Gillis.
He's just fucking...
He's just a regular guy.
And then, look, of course, the death of Shauna Grant. Like, oh. In related videos, like, these people always have the guys will live forever and just come back and tell the stories. Like, and they really do talk like, yeah, she was a hot piece of
hair. You're like, she's dead.
Yeah,
they're just, they're doing
that. Oh, too bad, too bad. I remember the first girl started shaving her asshole in the business. I remember she was an innovator, pioneer, if you will.
They always do that interview next to the picture with the flower wreath around it at her funeral. And they go, oh, yeah, she would lap it up like a dog with water.
Oh, you couldn't feed this girl enough cum. I think she was fueled by this stuff.
Yeah, I honestly, they say that, you know, humans are 75% water. I think she was 75% cum.
Yeah, just thick cum.
You know the saying, that girl's full of spunk? I think they legitimately meant it for her.
Yeah, Shauna Grant, she was a good girl.
Anyways, can't believe she got decapitated by that cartel. Cozumel. It sucks to be here, but, you know, I wouldn't mind if they popped that casket open, give it one more run.
Sometimes you guys want to see my collection of the silk shirts I still got from the days.
You guys want to watch me blink until my cock gets hard?
Oh, that yeah, you're play this. This will be, you'll hate both of these guys. Ron Jeremy and Peter North. Two of my favorite all-time porn stars.
And you think you're going to dislike them as because of their interviews?
Dude, Peter North, no guy that shoots loads that big is going to be a cool dude. He gets so much compliment on his big...
That's weird. No, pause it real quick. You know what's funny is that when you're a comic and people compliment you, go, dude, you're so funny. You go, thanks for him. It's like, dude, I love when you come.
I just love it so much. I love watching you slang dick, dude. But Peter North, I just love watching him. I watch Peter North cum shot compilations.
Just watch. Just him.
Well, I mean, there's girls involved.
Is that someone jumping into a pool?
All his heavy jizz.
There's fucking.
Yeah, I don't think it's just a shot of him. I think it's...
No, it's his dick shooting cum onto chicks.
When you watch it, you go... Is there noises?
No, I go...
By the way, which is just a funny way to watch Peter North go...
I mean, he's glass, too. Glass is legendary. Wait, you gotta get a better one. This is so VHS here.
Oh, look at that, dude.
Oh, Nina Harley.
Also, 80s, it was always...
Wait, here we go, wait. Oh, look at those loads. I met Nina Harley. First question to her, what's up with Peter North's loads? She gave me tablespoon measurements.
Oh. He goes, I'm in a weird place.
Taking one more. Oh, your favorite, Dan.
TFing.
Who's he TFing?
I don't know.
An elderly woman.
A lady that looks like she works at a fucking tow yard.
Oh. Yeah. Yup.
Do you think he would have ruined his career if he would have made those noises while he did it?
Yeah.
He goes, I have the biggest loads known to man. Well, what's the drawback? I make laser noises when I come.
Oh, Nina Harley. Shit. His dick wasn't even massive. It was good.
What a shower.
Guy had a killer piece, but
is it me, or were they much more supportive in 80s porn than they are now?
Oh, look at that. Look at her back, dude.
Wow.
I mean, that's awesome.
But back to how people are treated in porn now. It seems like they were a lot nicer back then. They're like complimenting. They're like, good job.
Well, it also used to be like... You were a porn star, and that was your business before the internet, where it was like, everybody can do porn.
Everybody, fuck!
Wait, Christine, do me a favor, just for dancing. Oh. God, do me a favor, you gotta back it up to the actual cum shot of this TF.
She took it right on the fucking
I know, but
chin.
I mean, like, come on. I mean, don't you don't envy that cum at all?
I mean, that'd be awesome, let one of those go.
Could you imagine?
I don't think it would, like...
This one here is, Lou, drink this in. Emotionally, I mean.
She's like, oh God. Oh, it's like God. She's in a room alone with a dog. She's like, is this thing going to bite me? All right, here we go.
Look, there's so much.
That's like
much.
A super soaker. That's like the first super soaker.
It never stops. Christine is a girl. Is that...
You know what's funny is most of his cum shots, the women start laughing, but like a real laugh. They're like, okay, all right, that's enough. That's Jesus. Can this guy...
I would guess Christine doesn't necessarily like preemptively go, I want that much cum on me. But wouldn't you feel like, holy shit?
I would feel so, like, accomplished and pretty.
You're like, I did all that.
I did that.
I removed your soul via cum.
I think we should take our break here, and then when we come back, we should get into a couple, watch some interviews of some of these guys.
Yeah, just to see.
I mean, if you stack them up next to a Feldog interview, I bet you're getting a similar thing. All right, one more. All right, before we
take
one more.
Laser time. Noises!
Oh, God.
Jacob, what is Jacob doing there?
Oh, it's still going.
Yes, yes.
Another rope.
Yes, yes.
I'm lying. I want to see one more. I mean,
yogurt. That's hilarious. What a hilarious screenshot to be.
Hey. I mean, he did it. Lou, you knew who Peter North was, didn't you?
Yeah. Everybody knows Peter North. I think outside.
I think a lot of people didn't.
I think under Ron Jeremy, he's the most norm porn star.
No, maybe. You think
I only know him because of Jay. Now I like want to watch.
Boom, bam, boom, bam, boom, bam. Boom, boom, boom.
It'd be great if one of the girls swatted it.
It's still coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Matrix loads.
Yeah. Catching it with her hands.
Redirecting it and sending it back to you.
How do you get...
Jizzbender.
I love the subtitles. It says, see, she loves it.
I mean, this is... Oh, like they're selling his cum.
He was so good.
His cum.
He was so good.
Cool shades, Peter. They did that a lot in the 80s.
Thank God she's Asian. Her eyes are already closed. Oh!
We'll be right back. It's the bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Ooh, that's sexy. Oh, yeah. Coming back with gas on the fire. Ooh, it's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio.
Comedy Central Radio.
Sirius XM 95. I'm just laying around in a silk robe. I'm Dan Soder. And with me, as always... My tag team partner in this devil's threesome, Big J. Oakerson. Now I'm going to need you to lay back. Yeah. And let me and Daddy Dan swallow you up. Get ready for heat and warmth. I'm giving back shots like blow,
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 blow.
Don't touch me.
Make me something neat. Get the fuck out this house. My main bitch coming home in like 15 minutes.
You gotta understand something, baby. You can't take all my time.
Pack a lunch, baby. Cause I'm gonna be eating out that snapping nappy dugout. 55 minutes.
You better put on a hard hat.
Cool.
I'll tell you what. To go to work.
On you.
Ooh.
This put me in a good mood. I came in.
A sensual bonfire tapes.
I came in, that's right, it's the bonfire lost tapes, and I came in hot.
Angry.
Hot today, and I'm happy Jacob's here. I'm not angry at Jacob at all, but I literally want something done about this.
What happened?
I hate to be this guy.
Okay. We're 4 days a week. You can be a little bit more of a diva.
I'd like to do the show when we can. By the way, I can fuck this up often, as anybody can be a little late or whatever. I know we're all rushing to get here, to be here on time to do the show. If we can, from the hour that we say we're going to do it, they say we can come in the studio at 5:00. And if we could go somewhere like 5:05 to 5:35, gives us a little more of a break before we start the live show.
Yeah.
And 5:05, 5:06, every time we come here, Fugelsang and his merry band of whoever the fucks are in here, and they always, I've always gotten the goddamn vibe from the people in that show, that they're like, oh, hey, kiddo, we'll get out of your hair. Don't worry, you know. Yeah. You don't get that from them?
I get the vibe of when you're at, have you ever been, this is such a meathead thing to say, but have you ever been at the gym and someone's using equipment and you ask to use their equipment and there's like a weird vibe where they're angry at you but you don't know why? Where you're like, hey, man, can I jump in? And they're like, yeah, I got two more sets. You're like, I just wanted to work out too. We're both here at this place. That's kind of the vibe I get, where they're always like, oh, oh, you guys want to use it now? All right, yeah, well, I mean, I guess I'm just going to change my life for you. And you're like, Jacob reserved it.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just a lot of like, I think.
Should we just come in guns blazing one time? Sons of Gary vests? Who made those rockers online? Someone had a great, was it Kevy Kev? Who made the ones with, or was it Dan, someone tweeted at us where they had the...
The parrot head?
Yeah,
the parrot head. Oh, look, I can't remember off the top of my head, but I
say we come
right
in
now.
Rocking those and just fucking beat it, Fugelsang. I say we come in like Jackass with those buzzers and take a piece of his hair off.
Yeah, maybe.
He's got gorgeous hair.
He does have gorgeous hair, and I think it's a bit of a dye job. I think there's a lot of gray in there. That's
you think he's going Teddy Danson last couple seasons of Cheers?
I think he is. I feel like the roots are coming in all gray.
I remember when I learned that about Ted Danson, it fucking shocked me because that was before the internet. And then they were like, do you know Ted Danson dyes his hair for Cheers? And they're like, shut up.
It's totally gray.
Showed a gray. You're like, no way.
Yeah, as soon as he showed up.
Right Ted Danson the white. the gray. I should have said the gray.
I feel that. Jacob, your thoughts at all? I feel like there's no rush. And I feel like they're kind of doing like, oh, yeah, you guys going to come dick around and do your little thing now? All right, we'll jump out of here. And it's like, there's never seems to be a real. I see they still.
There
like,
it is. It was Daniel Plainview. Or at, I can't remember his name.
That's awesome.
God, those are awesome.
As they come out, like, they'll stop doing, like, a few more sentences of conversation.
Yeah, it's
where it's
a casual
let's get the fuck out.
They take their time.
So what do you think? Do you think we come in and go, hey, all of you, time to fuck off. And sons of Gary's are here, and I got two words for you. Beat it. And I got damn liberal left Nancy's. I don't know if you guys want to jerk each other off with your damn equal opportunity employment. I know you guys are hanging out here sucking each other's stink pickles. You want to walk in here? I know you guys are laying belly to back. I know you've become the beast with two dicks, but can you do it in Studio 4, perhaps? Hey, if you want to have Hydra sex, that's fine with me, but it's an abomination. That's enough, sissies. Enough of your damn Castro district assless chap talk. It's men time. You clams are going to hang out and lay stomach pancakes on each other. Why don't you take it over to Studio 4 where they like that kind of shit it out? Okay. Enough of you guys gurgling with boy batter. Time for you to get out of here. Yeah, we should. I think we should just come in hard.
We're joking. It genuinely bothers me, and I'm not. This is where me and Dan differ. I feel like Dan, if it maybe not in this situation, but you are definitely like a step up and say something before I am.
Yeah,
I mean, it's funny. I was telling. I said to Christina that day. I keep busting her balls about being a pussy.
Yeah.
Like, she's, for sure, but I'm a pussy, not out of fear. I guess maybe some partially out of fear, but I'm a put with, I do not like to, I don't like asking for money IMO. I don't like all that. Yeah. And by the way, it's because I feel like the person's going to be shitty with me, and then I have to go shitty. And then it's like, now we're in a fight.
I have a
because I'll be so much more angry that I was like, I don't even want to have this talk at all, but I kind of have to, you know what
yeah,
I mean?
You go, get shitty. If I go 0-60, you go 0 to Bruce Lee, like in Game of Death, not Game of Death, Fist of Fury, where they rip the necklace off him, where he's like, I won't fight, and they tear the necklace, and he's like, bah! Just beats the fuck out of the whole ice factory. That's what you do, where you're like,
yes.
I don't want a problem. I don't want a problem.
I don't,
and then they push you, and you're like, ah!
Yeah, then the Hulk out.
Then you crowd work him to death.
Yeah.
What have you, you're like, what have you been up to?
What do you do? What a loser. That's a job for a teenager.
You just keep going in on him. Where's your mom? Sucking dick? This guy's destroying me.
I bet your sister's fucking a black guy.
He starts bleeding. Fugelsang starts bleeding out of his brain.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all. It bothers me, and I want to say, like,
I understand the energy that you're talking about.
I don't enjoy that energy. I feel the whole thing's. I feel like they don't think about it for 3 seconds past walking out this door or us showing up. But I almost feel like that's the problem in it. I feel like they don't have an urgency where it's like, oh shit, well, we gotta be out the door here at 5.
Yeah.
That would weigh on me. If we had a show that came in here at 8 o'clock, that came in here right after us, it would be weighing on me that we're like, let's wrap our show at like 3 and get the fuck out of here.
Let me give you an example. When Sam Roberts had his show from 9 to 12, or it was like, I think it was after Opie and Jim, and then Sam would do his show. When was it? I mean, Lou, you were around for that.
Yeah, it would be after the show. I was doing the show before. It'd be like Race Wars.
Yeah.
Would be on, and then they would leave a kind of a mess for him.
But before Sam moved to nights, when Sam was in afternoons, I remember I did it once, and Bennington was coming in, and we were having like a great time, and he's like, all right, we gotta get the fuck out of here. I'm like, why? He's like, 10 minutes, Bennington's coming in. So at 10 minutes, he stopped the show and got everyone out of there.
Yeah.
So there was like this, like, we gotta fuck off. Someone's coming in. This is someone's.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then, you know.
And they're done before five. When
do they end?
They're done.
5 o'clock?
They're always just sitting around, dicking around.
I'll give them if they end at 5.
They probably
end
a couple of minutes before 5.
Yeah, like 5 minutes before.
4:58 or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, you're right, Jay. Let me just work on it, all right? Let me take care of it.
Yeah, no,
it's true.
I'm telling you, I'm not. You are. We are a million miles away from me saying anything about it.
Oh man, but you know what?
But on the radio, and this, where I can grieve here, and probably yes, apply that to see what you can do to handle that. But I really don't. I hate.
Let me tell you about the vibe.
We can't complain about the vibe to anybody, but like.
But you talked about how you're bad at conflict.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you right now what's going to happen now from this. What's going to result is the thing that bothers me the most, where there's weird energy at all. Because I'm like a kind of person, like, I'll get confrontation out of the way to clear the energy, or the vibe. To be like, hey man, fuck this shit. Either, like, I've said that to people before at bars and they've been blown away, where I'm like, hey, if there's any shittiness between us, let's just go outside and fight. Because then there won't be shittiness between us. Because then we'll punch each other in the face, and then you'll get that out of you. So I'd rather do that than sit there and be, you know, like stared at, or like, you know, there's a person, I'm not going to bring it up on
air. For long stretches of time.
There's a person that we know in comedy that I have a problem with. I won't say male or female, but they've been going around saying shitty stuff about me, and I'm the type.
Fight her.
Yeah, I would love to. But there's a part where. I know my own self, and I just need to let that go.
I just assume it's a girl.
Yeah.
I go, fight her.
And
I won't be a man or a woman. Whatever it is, bite it.
Yeah, bite it and kick it. I go, Jay, is that your advice? You go, got a tattooed on my calf, bud. Bite it or kick it. But there's a thing of, I need to learn how to be cool, just that energy being out there of them not liking me. And I'm telling you, like, I don't mind coming in here and being like, hey guys, can you fuck off early? If it would kill the energy. But if this changed it to where we're walking down the hall and I see him, I'll be like, this is fucking weird.
I'll nose to nose him in the hallway. I don't give a shit. I'll go for the physical.
Well, no, I'm fine with it. I'm saying like the continuation of the weird.
Yeah, no, me either.
I'd rather
headbutt him in the hallway.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you are going zero to Bruce Lee.
Yeah, but no, I don't want anything really to happen. But yes, and I'd love it to be, and that's why I'm saying, like, almost, I still have the lack of confrontation where I'm like, in the complaint, obviously, you don't have to say that they, I feel like we're being disrespected.
Yeah.
It can just be like, it's like, hey, we kind of like, for our scheduling, we got to start the thing. Like, by 5 after 5, we have to be recording.
I do like the
and
higher.
We need a few minutes to set up.
I do like the higher ups getting a memo that says we feel we're being disrespected. We're I'm just telling you, President Sirius, I just feel like I'm getting mad disrespected when I come in there.
No,
you know what I mean?
Why,
like,
fuck your bitch.
I don't do politics.
Oh, Hugo Stan, here we come.
First off, fuck you in the hair you die. We're gonna start.
Wild beast, little bitch, hanging by your side.
Oh, you gonna think we're gonna do this?
Oh,
you
claim to be a player,
but I fucked your wife. I'll watch the defiant ones. I'll go after
Hell
who
yeah.
I like.
That's right.
I mean, it would crush me.
Leah Bonham on the show today, walking out all bottom heavy with that booty cracking. Hey. I was gonna go, that's why I fucked Leah Bonham. If I didn't fuck Leah Bonham.
That's why I changed your screen. That's why I changed your screensaver, you liberal motherfucker. Take money.
Actually, that's part of the funny thing in here is like today Leah Bonham was here and Ryan Reese, and it's like, I know them and I like them, but both, so it's as they're walking out, there's like that. But I feel like they're getting my flack for me being like, nah, this isn't your guy's fault, I understand, but this guy you just did his show,
you're doing
fucking
that.
Treat me like a straight-up bitch right now.
You're trying to do the capped anger where you're going, hey, good to see
it's
you,
great
too.
To see you, Ryan. It was great to see both of them.
I'll see you guys. No, I don't know where you guys at later today. Okay. All right, John. Hey, John, if you could, can I have a word with you? That would be great. Hey, John, can I take you, can we talk real quick? Just do that,
John, do me a favor. Give me 5 reasons right now why I shouldn't just fucking put you through this portal.
No, you always got to ask with a question. You go, do you not respect me? He goes, what?
You don't respect me, do you?
He goes, I don't know what you're talking about, Dan. Well, it's just, you know, we've gone out of our way to reserve the studio at 5. I mean, we don't go to live at 6, but we're also doing a show at 5. So the question comes back down, and I just need an answer real quick. Do you not respect me?
Dan, I don't want any problems. I'm just doing Dan, I don't want any problems here.
I'm not saying there's going to be problems. I just got to figure out the answer to this question right now.
I mean, this is what Trump wants, is two brothers. First off,
you're not my brother. I've never met you before. I don't even think that's your real last name. So here's what we're going to happen. I'm going to tell you three things that are going to happen. Number one, I'm going to start showing up every day at 5:05. Number two, if you're in the room, I'm going to go nuclear.
Dad, listen, I'm going to adhere to all these things. Ryan Reese, go low, I go high.
Yeah. Dude, I think it'll be fine. Jacob will talk to it. Jacob will make threats.
John, it'd be a shame if you went in one day and one of the lights was unscrewed. And it just kind of dropped on you.
He also really wails the lights in here. It's like a goddamn terrarium when we walk in.
He's got lizard lighting. He goes in. He's just on a hot rock.
You got a hot rock in the middle of the table here. He goes, the debates, your thoughts.
He goes, is there collusion in Russia? I don't. Next question. What's better?
Is POTUS guilty of treason?
Yeah. What's...
Gets a fly.
Is Donald Trump Jr. actually meeting with Russian intelligence? Now, second question. Which part of the rock is hotter? Oh, I think I found it.
Now, your argument here is that John Fugel saying has no respect for us, treats us like bitches, like chumps. I wanted to get around the studio because someone just walked in. That John Fugelsang treats the bonfire like a couple of bitches.
Just because we're not intellectual.
He doesn't treat us like we're fucking five whites and a black. He treats us like we're five blacks and one white. Yeah, that's how he looks at us.
Treats us like a bunch of roller rink whores.
What am I, some bowling alley bar slag? Fuck you.
I'm sorry, I don't pay attention to the news.
I'll let you get through here.
Someone lean over Jay to work on a computer while Jay's trying to talk is not the best.
I just wanted to get my leg free.
I just
want to be in the studio at 5:05.
I think we'll be fine.
By the way, Fugel's saying his whole, he's infected our call system now. Literally, it says POTUS politics, all the phone lines. He's fucked us so hard and so royally. Is he still in the building?
It goes back.
Jacob, lure him in here. I'm going to beat him up.
It goes back in a time where he's on the phone with two Garys going, I think you need to leave your kid.
Dude, he's the
start of all of this. Like when you find out in Tim Burton's Batman that it was the Joker that killed his parents.
Dan, can we get him in here?
Let's go on the show.
Can we get him in here? And I want you to give him that rap you gave.
Yeah, what?
You'd go, do I look like a bitch?
Yeah, that's funny. You go, hey, John, I don't know if we've ever talked about this. Do you think I pee sitting down? No.
That's weird. Knows, but you think it's a...
It's weird that
you... Is my pussy a little puffy? He goes, so I don't think you have a pussy. He goes, oh, then that must be my dick. A man. Treat me like one.
Hey, I should just... I just got a quick question for you, Fugues. What color is my labia? It's so weird just because
I love it. I'm gonna start doing mine with the fake karate moves I'm about to do afterwards.
You yeah. Know
what I mean? I'm like, hey, Fugelsang, I got a question for you. Do you see lipstick on my face? Yeah. Is there any? No? Oh, it's probably because I'm not a bitch. Chop to the throat.
Okay, I like that better. Yeah, you got to have that come in different where you go, oh, hey, John, real quick, if I could talk to you by High Heat, the High Heat studio. Yeah, I just wanted to know if you're going to give me back that Barbie I let you borrow. Oh, I didn't let you borrow a Barbie? Then stop treating me like a little girl.
Yeah! Double chest punch.
Yeah!
What did he do? How did he fix it? Oh, he has to turn off all the Fugelsang shit?
Pretty much, yeah. It was still logged in D.C. somehow. They changed it over to the D.C.
Angry Baby hates us when he has to come in here.
And that's because fucking, you know, he is Angry Baby. Puppy Monkey Baby.
Puppy Monkey Baby.
Puppy Monkey Baby. Hey, our phone screen seems to be all wrong. Puppy Monkey Baby. Okay. Is that, is it, does that, do I hit Control Alt Puppy Monkey Baby? Puppy Monkey Baby.
I thought Angry Baby was going to be the best nickname, but man, you just shot the wad on that one.
A puppy what? Monkey Baby when he comes in. Puppy That's Monkey him. Baby. He's so angry. Yeah. Puppy Monkey.
Puppy Monkey Baby. Puppy Monkey Baby.
That's the guy who comes puppy in here. Baby. Puppy Monkey Baby. He hates us.
Just pure hatred when he walks in. We
What's
are not
the
making
Why
a lot
are
of
we
friends.
So not popular?
Hey, hey, Puppy We're Monkey. So hey, Puppy Monkey Baby. Can I talk to you real quick outside? Hey, did someone not clean your cage?
He's gonna.
Oh, he goes. What? Did someone not clean your cage? Oh, okay. Because you're treating me like an animal. I'm about to treat you like an animal. So.
I like sending Puppy Monkey Baby back with a message.
There you go.
Fugle sang Puppy Monkey Baby. Guess what? Puppy Monkey Baby.
They don't like you. Puppy Monkey Baby.
Bonfire's talking mad shit. Puppy Monkey Baby.
They feel disrespected. Puppy Monkey Baby.
They feel... They said something about you're treating them like bitches, and then they start doing examples of that Puppy Monkey Baby.
I love that. Hey, hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? Hey, where's your furry coat? What? Oh, your furry coat and your cane and your big hat. What do you mean? Oh, because I thought you were trying to pimp us. Because it feels like you're trying to pimp us. Yeah!
Hey, John, does my hair look better in a ponytail or pigtails, you think? Yeah. Oh, neither? Oh, it's probably because I'm a man. Headbutt! Yeah.
Glasgow kiss!
Flying scissor!
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm, alright, well, what are you gonna do, Jacob? I mean, I think we've thrown the gauntlet down. Puppy Monkey Baby's going back with that info. He's gonna say something.
Yeah, easily. I bet.
I feel like he's fucking, like, that guy seems like he's boys with Fugelsang.
And I bet he's in Ben and Deb's pocket. I bet he's cool with, I bet he's on the side of everyone that's against us.
From the fucking day we walked into the studio, and John Fugelsang gave me a tour of it like it was his fucking bedroom he was letting us borrow. It made me fear. He literally assigned to me the things that are his and with his idea. This,
he gave you an Airbnb.
A surge protector, which I refused to use because he made such a big deal. Because we brought, I swear to you, he goes, yeah, we brought, that's ours, but you could feel free, you could use it. He said you could use it. It's a fucking surge protector.
He gave you an Airbnb tour.
Oh,
he
goes, I did
all right,
not
if
like
you
it.
Stay here real quick. That light, little thing. Also, I like to have the lights on as bright as possible on me. I like to be blinded, but also.
I recycle nothing here ever because he told me he made a thing
Jay,
to make you get recycled. I don't give a shit.
No, don't take it out on planet Earth.
Oh, I am. It's going down to Earth. Earth, you got Fugelsang to thank for this. Lou is here. You came in and I told you how frustrating that was.
Yeah.
You remember the first day we were in the studio? I go, man, I'm already like, the
yeah,
vibe is very much.
Here.
I mean, we always come in. The pylons are never ours. It's fine. Care. What? Gives a shit.
But it's not his either.
No, I know. I'm just saying, like, but there's, as far as, like, our stamp on the studio. I mean, we're the best thing happened in Studio 5. We have to be. At least fun-wise.
We need pylon interns.
We need pylon interns.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just to hold flags up, like Game of Thrones.
I love John's perspective on this whole thing. It's probably a 180 from what you guys are feeling.
Yeah, he's like, oh, man, I'm sorry. I was just hanging out for a
I had
bit.
No idea. We ended our show, and
we're
it's just a couple minutes.
Yeah, we're just shooting the shit afterwards.
I'm telling you, it's not even, I said that. I already pointed that out. I said, he's not thinking about it.
But to get us back to the topic that we're going to talk about today, but that is true, is that is something that we as overthinkers take, where we take like that, like, oh, they're disrespecting me because of this. Very few dumb people do that. They don't, like, look into that much, or they'd probably be like, oh, you're just hanging out. Like, good looking dudes who are kind of dumb are just like, thanks for hanging out, man. Is it cool if we jump in? Violent dumb dudes are like, I'm gonna do something about it. Like, they walk in with a bottle and like, but you know what I
Somebody's
mean?
Somebody's gonna die tonight. Hey,
Fugelsang!
I'm just walking out with a knife scraping against the wall.
Both walls?
Yeah!
Down the hallway?
You ready to play?
You got one of those, you got a fucking Clockwork Orange eye?
Hey, Fugelsang!
say, time's up. Fugal scene.
Hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? I just want to know, should I get a landing strip or just bikini wax?
What?
For my pussy.
Oh, I don't think you have a pussy.
Oh, cool. Then why are you laying over me with your arms locked trying to fuck me like I have one? Get out of our studio. Or I'm going to take you to Pound Town and not the fun type.
Do you want to, this to be full girlfriend experience where I kiss you while you fuck me? Or do you want me to just pay face down the pillow just shutting my stupid bitch yap? Mm-hmm. Because I just want to know, how do you like your ladies? Because that's what you're treating me like. Yeah. A goddamn lady. Nutshot!
Hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? I just wanted to tell you that I don't know if you know, but Jay and I have never been to Japan.
Why would I think you guys are going to Japan?
Oh, because you're treating us like a couple geishas. So,
yeah! Leapfrog sidekick! That was me coming in over your hit.
Whoa! Out of nowhere! Yeah. All right, but we were, before the break, we were talking about, well, we watched Peter North's cum shot compilation, which we found out can be fun if you do laser noises. But the reason I brought up Fugelsang was because he is a handsome man, and he does have nice hair. Uh-huh. And it could be handsome guy confidence.
Sure.
That is the reason he's treating us the way it is. He's like, you guys still want to fuck me? I'm like, I totally do. Even though I feel disrespected, I still want your approval.
Do we have, anyway, I know we said we wanted to watch some interviews with porn stars.
So yeah, just because they're kind of the opposite of us as far as like.
I don't want to dig too deep into this because we only have like 2 or 3 minutes left.
Well, we'll start one off and just see how good it is.
Oh, yeah, because we got a bunch.
Yeah, Nick Manning,
it's so long. We can't. Dive right into that. That's going to be a whole thing.
He was on Stern a lot, right?
Nick Manning.
Was he one of the gigolo guys?
No.
Okay.
He's just Nick Hawk. Hilarious. Nick Hawk is who
that's
I,
who we talked about. Because we talked about
because I met him. I did an FDR show with him. Mr. Pete, here you go. Porn star Mr. Pete, 2 minutes, 11 seconds.
This is Mr. Pete, because this is Rated X Life.
Now, here's the question. This looks like it's going to be one of those interviews where porn stars do one of two things. They either completely glorify the lifestyle or they shit on it. Like if they're out.
This
like
is going like, to be glorified.
Yeah, this is going to be like, there's nothing better than just slamming a bunch of hot poon all day at a nice pool and some catering. I pretty much got it made.
Crafty and
decent.
Pussy.
Crafty, someone else's pool that I ain't got to clean, and some beef.
Yeah. Oh, man, I'd say shock that pool when we get out because I blasted off horde.
Yeah. Oh, man, unless you guys got a net and some goggles, you want to dip under there and fish all my jizz out. I let a load go. It was like an oil spill.
I let a load go.
Yeah, you might as well call that the Gulf of Mexico because I dropped some oil in there. I dropped some baby oil in
there. Valdez'd it.
I Valdez'd it. Oh, you guys might want to clean that pool out. I just Exxon Valdez'd that shit.
Valdez'd that.
Valdez'd these Valdez nuts. Oh, goddamn it. We were both going for the same thing.
Christina Blake, go ahead.
I'd say you'd describe Mr. Pete as aggressively passionate.
What?
Would be the best way to put it, you know? Tons of energy. I love what I do. I love women, so it's a perfect fit. Porn has been an outlet for me to live out all my sexual fantasies. The weird kinky stuff, the aggressive stuff.
I just really wanted to kick the shit out of girls for a long time.
He's pointed at aggression twice in the first 27 seconds.
He goes, what do I love best about porn? Probably I can be so aggressive. It's more like it's chains off. Like I'm just kind of, you know, someone took the dog off the leash. I'm going to eat.
You know what? We're going to take a commercial break because even this 2 minutes is going to take us. I'm telling you, this is a gold mine.
Oh, God.
A treasure trove.
But you don't think we can get through a little bit more? Just a little taste. One more line.
I'll take one more taste.
Yeah. It's a little more.
I want to watch the whole thing.
Yeah, so throughout porn, I've been able to have my cake and eat it, too.
He goes, but I beat the cake. Then I fuck it.
Yeah.
I'm super aggressive.
Before I eat my cake, I like to beat my cake.
He goes, I'm super aggressive with the cake.
The eggs. I beat the mix.
He just keeps talking about how aggressive he is. He goes, I get kind of my cake and eat it too, but aggressively eat it.
Sometimes I order pizza, but like aggressive pizza. I'm like, get it over here now. You better not drop it. Don't put your dick in my cheese. I know you're angry at me now.
You better slice it. Why don't you put peppers on there? I want aggressive pizza.
Here's your money. Now give it.
Yeah,
give the pizza.
All right, yeah, a little more.
I know all the characters that are in porn, whether, you know, I've produced them or I've worked with them, so I know all the characters.
It's time out. Much this dude's talking like he's really, like a boxer. Like, he's going a little slow, like he's had some, like his brain's been rattled.
Yeah, and he's like chin up, like he's a weird, like.
But when you watch old boxers and like, it's really fun just getting in the ring with the guy. I mean, I'm doing Rocky, but it's.
Yeah, it's like the next thing you know, we fought three times.
Yeah.
They're always confused. Let him play for another couple seconds.
He could hit strong.
But
for
I'm into pictures. Like,
pause it for a second. We'll let it go for the next.
He called it the pictures.
Back up a few seconds.
Mr. Pete, we want to put you in the aggressive pictures.
Let this, right there. Let this play straight through to 1 minute. Let's see if this is literally the least I could like somebody in 1 minute of interview.
Okay.
Possible. Let's uninterrupt him for the next 22 seconds.
Produce them, or I've worked with them, so I know all the characters. It's not as much of a turn on, but I am into pictures. I like the pics, you know. I generally don't watch my own porn. On occasion, I do when I'm producing stuff. You know, at the end of the movie, I want to see how it came out after it's edited. So in those aspects, but I never watch just general scenes and try to critique myself. I just
I'm on board. I think I like the guy. He's in it for the art. You know, he does it and then he gives it to the people and then he has them consume. And I think that's, you know, that's the true mark of an artist. So
well, you turned me. I'm a Mr. Pete guy.
He also looks like a McDonald's manager in that fucking red shirt and red tie. He goes, I know all the characters. I know where they drop off the money. You're like, is this a bank heist?
Let's go time travel.
And, are you ready to join the bonfire through time? We'll return in just a few minutes.
But to us, hours.
Will Dan advance his created character on UFC 2? Will Dan and Jay do a Dave Attell benefit?
Will Dan and Jay find what John Fugelsang lives from H&R and personally attack him?
All that coming up later.
Just a few commercials.
On the bonfire through time.
And don't forget, next Wednesday, we're going to be doing our two-year anniversary show live at the Just for Last Festival in Montreal. Oh, yeah. We'll be in the Soprano C Room at the Hyatt Regency Hotel, which is awesome, centrally located. This is a free show for our fans. For our fans, then, if they want to come, it's free. So if you can make it to the show and you'd like tickets, email us at The Bonfire, starting with the THE Bonfire SXM at gmail.com. It's The Bonfire SXM at gmail.com. If you're a fan in the Montreal area, on our 2 year anniversary show, please, please, please come out and support. We'd love to meet you. We'd love to see you and make you laugh. Other than that, we'll catch you right back after these words.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
I love Christine, and I bake.
Olivia Newton-John doesn't just get physical. She gets emotional. It's the bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J. Oakerson, and this is the lost tapes of the bonfire. And I'll tell you right now.
A lot's happened through that commercial break.
Through time and space. Dan Soder's became a John Fugelsang ally. I didn't know he was a soda-holic. That's what I'm calling my fans from now on. That's actually not.
I'm telling you, I get nothing but the bad vibes from that guy.
So,
I think, here's the thing, by the way, I think he likes you. I think he does not, something about him does not like me.
You just feel like he doesn't like you.
Dude, I'm telling you, and Lou did a fucking flip-flop too. This little queen bee over here who fucking got all hot in the box for fucking tall, handsome Fugelsang.
Fugelsang walked by and went, hey, Lou, is that a different plaid shirt? He went, it is.
Thanks for noticing.
He goes, hey, Lou, you smell terrific today.
Complete me.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Lou flipped too, but Lou was right here when he came in. He goes,
I like how immediately you changed the tone.
That's the tone. He goes, yeah. He goes, we'll make sure not to leave the place a pigsty for you, huh?
And then, there was a huh?
I don't want to swear to the huh.
Okay.
That's the correct vibe, though, but
that is the vibe. Okay, and then really just like, and he goes, so you guys are like every day now, huh? Every day, and we were like, no, it's just 3 days. He goes, oh, I just thought you guys were every day at this point. And they were like, no, it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. He's like, no, okay. And then you came in and he lit up.
Yeah,
he's a soda maniac.
It's the like when the he's a sodaholic. It's like when the frog in the WB where he doesn't sing, where he's like, brop, and then I come in, he's like, hello, ragtime. My baby, hello, my darling, hello, my ragtime gal. He goes, Dan Soder, I love your radio. I come in, he's
oh, I jacked off to your billboard in L.A. Yeah, he says,
well, that's what he said. He goes, you have a billboard in L.A. for the Netflix The Stand-Ups, and I didn't know that.
He brought you good info, and now you're just on his team. That's
he goes, fun. Hey, crazy story, Dan. Before your dad died, I actually had dinner with him, and he told me he's proud of you. So,
dude. You're singing the Fugelsang song.
I just think he's a handsome man who has good points.
That's fine. I'm thinking about rebooting a lot of my friendships. All my friendships.
You know I'm ride or die, even if he doesn't.
I'm going. Like, I mean, I'm starting a new life on like the Upper West or something. Oh, upper West Side of
that'd be crazy. I'd go, hey, I was on 87th and I swear to God I saw Big J.
Because you started over.
Yeah, now he calls himself Large Mark.
Large Larry Oakerson.
Large Larry Oakerson. I go,
still Oakerson?
Yeah. I go, you just need to drop Oakerson? There you go, that's my new life.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my
that's Fugelsang when he sees me.
Oh, Dan's here. Ha cha cha cha. Fuck him.
Dude, we were laughing so hard in the office because you told me you were like, and out of nowhere, he followed me on Twitter.
Yeah.
And you still feel like it's a bully move.
Yeah, I think he did it because he thought I was you at first. He's like, oh, wait, no, it's the other guy.
Shit, I can't unfollow him. Goes, well, he can't followed me now. Back, the little bitch.
Little fucking fat oinker's going to sit there and cry squeaky tears into a fucking handkerchief.
I don't want to give him bacon tears. He's just vicious. He's vicious when I'm not around. Dude, I didn't know he was doing that to you. You go, yeah, it's pretty bad. He goes, what's wrong? Little pork chop gonna cry? Jesus Christ, Fugelsang.
Hey, Piggy. Yeah. Piggy gonna cry?
He goes, oh, what's wrong? You need to crawl out of your slop to do a radio show? I come in, he goes, I mean, you guys are legitimately hilarious. I'm like, what the fuck? What the hell's happening here?
Oh, is this what it sounds like when the pigs cry?
And then I walk in, hey, what's going on, guys?
Oh, bro, what's up?
Hey, dude. Saw you on a billboard in L.A. It was like, about time, right? You all right?
Yo, fucking Tubbs was telling me you guys aren't every day yet. That's fucking sickening, man. You should be every day. You're that talented. But you're so talented, you're probably busy with other projects.
He goes, he walks in.
I get it. Anyway.
He goes, what's up?
Pink belly, fat boy. All right, Soder, we'll catch you later.
God, are you going to cry now?
Yeah, he goes,
come on, Soder, cry, baby. Cry,
Soder, keep killing him. Hey, watch out for the beaties. All right, I'll see you later. I go, Jesus. I just hear him making that noise in the hallway. I go, why does he do that?
Why is he doing that pig crying?
Why is this little piglet pig crying?
Anyway. Before we all chose our allegiances differently.
Oh, hey, you know me, I'm ride or die with you. If you don't like Fugelsang, I'll still shave his head.
It's not true. You're all about him. All about him now.
You get caught in that charming beam.
I've seemed to have avoided it somehow. I've avoided the charming beam. This is the episode still. We haven't fully gotten through these male porn star.
Well, I mean, we didn't get fully through Mr. Pete's.
I know. Because it was making me too happy, everything he was saying.
It was making you angry happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go back. Can you go back to it, Christine? Christine's just trying to hack into Fugelsang's email. Because... he looks like an awkward employee at
self-made man, big Fugelsang fan.
Yeah. I think John Fugelsang's got the key to life. Also, I'm a go-getter. So if you hire me at this insurance company, the way he's dressed looks like he works at an insurance company. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook. If you want to see the videos we're watching.
God damn it, Dan. He gave me the vibe that he knows I fucking talked.
Is that what it was?
And it went back
to... That was the vibe he gave you.
Out of nowhere goes, hey, we'll do our best to keep the room nice and tidy.
I wasn't here for
that. We won't leave our mess. What do you say, Lou? We'll do our best to clean up our pigsty before we leave. That was unsolicited. I didn't ask for anything.
Did he make eye contact with you when he said pig?
I came in like a poon and just act like I was on my phone and stood over here to let them pass.
Yeah.
And they started asking me a bunch of questions.
He goes like this. He goes, who are you texting?
What's up, Chops?
He calls you Chops. He goes, looks like the butcher let you out early today, huh? You slice of ham?
Hey, Chops.
I'm surprised you guys have a Jew producer, considering you're made of pork.
You, hey, chin up. You got a problem with the way we leave the studio? He goes,
yeah? Hey, I didn't know, yeah. I knew you were a pig. I didn't know you were a canary bird. I didn't know you sang.
Oh, I'm getting hungry for a BLT. Just breathe in your salty skin. You tell HR on me again.
Threatening Hugo.
I'll fucking make bacon strips out of you, Tubbs.
Pink belly.
Hey, heads up. Heads up. If you rat on me again, I'm going to turn you into a goddamn pork chop. Yeah, he didn't realize that Jacob ratted on him, really. I made a public thing. I'll fight him.
Dude, I would love if after this episode's air, if we walk in and there's just a mouse trap hanging from the ceiling after they leave, and it just says snitch with it fucking locked out.
It's hanging from, there's a mouse trap hanging from a noose.
Yeah, and
Jacob goes, hey, John, we were here a little earlier yesterday, and that noose with the mouse trap, he goes, oh,
do you know what that means?
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know? Because I think you know where HR is. Because you sure as shit walked in there and bitched about me and my family.
What'd you say, Jacob?
I just asked my boss to ask them, you know, to leave a little early.
Who's your boss?
Don.
Don Wicklund. Oh, he's got such an unpleasant... He's got such a boss face.
Cowboy boots on?
He definitely told them with an air of like, hey, guys, come on. Stop fucking these guys over.
Hey, we got a lot of money in these two idiots.
Get out of the goddamn room. Don't be a fuck about it.
Hey, Fugelsang, I let you talk. Now you let my boys talk.
And he probably gave him dressed them down a little bit. And now they came back here and they assume it's me. I look like the one who's going to run and tell.
You don't, though.
I don't. You're right.
Jacob does.
I know, but they're...
I think Fugelsang's just carrying energy because you know what I think it is? I think he's threatened by you. I don't think he's threatened by me. That's why he's nice to me.
Best hair in studio?
Yeah.
Maybe.
But also, I think he's just got an air of, like, the gravity of the room, you know? He's used to being the gravity of the room of his show. You're the gravity of the room of this show.
No, I don't think I'm the gravity. I don't know if I have that kind of maybe I do. I don't think I have that kind of presence. It's not even that he strikes me as he does.
Maybe he's just trying to pick a fight with you.
He
goes, meet me in between 47th and 48th at the waterfall. 4 p.m., I'm going to fucking break your face.
Half floor?
Yeah, no, but you know what I'm talking about in the street?
By the waterfall? Oh, yeah.
He goes, hey, meet me at the waterfall, 3:30 p.m. tomorrow. I'm going to break your fat fucking face. You go, Jesus, Fugelsang.
My ring's outside, Chops. Pink belly.
Yeah. Body glove. He goes, surf the tide. Ow, man.
Lou, you don't feel that?
No, I think it's like the, he's being like, hey, I'm a comedian too, you know. Let's talk shop over here. Hey, Sodes, I saw your fucking billboard. Good punchlines or whatever you guys say.
I think he's saying we're all comedians here.
Because he's a comedian. And he wants to be like one of you guys, like a good comedian, not just a fucking political dickbag.
Let me see his comedy.
dude, this is going to go down a dark place.
But he's also...
That's why I was dead silent for about 15 seconds of thinking.
You did the sniper breath. You went,
put it on.
Sure. Listen, man, this will escalate it to a war.
All right, don't put it on. Now everyone at home really wants us to put it on.
Maybe just a little bit. Maybe just a taste. Then we go to the porn star interviews.
I was going to say, if Christine was funny at all, she would just start playing this and said it was his comedy.
Yeah.
John Fugelsang's comedy just Mr. Pete's the rest of his interview.
He goes,
oh, man, crushing ass.
I'm pretty aggressive. I don't like to watch myself. I'm not that crazy.
But I'm pretty aggressively not crazy.
I'm just pretty aggressive.
I'm aggressively sane.
I'm just aggressively, like, I'm aggressively happy to be here.
That's not my show, Fugelsang's comedy.
Well, let's watch Mr. Let's go.
Now you want to? All right, Dan wants to.
I didn't say that. I said let's watch Mr. Pete.
Dan's all goosed up to watch it.
I mean, not really, but
Jacob. I mean, Lou's giving me a thumbs down. He already says he knows it sucks.
I'm not into politics. That's all. Political humor, especially.
Well, Lou, for the record, can I theater the mind? But we're not giving a thumbs down. I'm making that. Yeah. You just accepted that. I go, Lou's giving a thumbs down. Like he already knows it sucks. Lou's like, that's not my thing. you accepted it completely.
I took improv class at Burton Community College. Guy, I know where you were going with that. I was playing along.
Yeah, he was yes anding you.
Gah.
Thank you so much, Lou. That's a guy you want in your corner.
Lou?
Oh, man.
Yes and Lou?
Oh, yeah. I want Lou in the... Yes
old,
and Lou?
Oh, a little Lou Yes and Witzky?
Oh, I would take Lou back me up in a bar fight. I bet Lou can scrap.
1,000%.
Drunk, he'll throw, I bet. Yeah.
I bet when he gets violent, there you just hear a distant bell ring, but not like a fighting bell, but like a... Like one of those bells where it's like, ding, ding, ding. And he's like, you just flipped the switch, bro.
Like a Vietnam flashback or
yeah,
something?
You just take off the Mets hat and you put it where your beer, over your beer. You go, I'll be right back for both of these.
That's what he does. He goes out back, he takes off his Pearl Jam shirt, folds it up, puts it in his car, and then buttons up his over button down.
And then he
that's his fighting shirt, the button down.
He goes like this, he goes, blood washes off easier. Goes, plus you can buy it at his store. PJ shirts, you gotta go to the show. Let's do this.
When's the last fight you've been in, Lou?
Usually.
What?
Because it's seasonal.
You have a usual?
It's fall.
Last one, I think, was with my twin brother, 8 years ago.
Oh, wow.
That was the last one?
But those are the best ones because it's like fighting yourself.
Yeah,
he has the same moves. He knows how to hurt you more than anybody.
Twins can scrap.
Yeah.
When I was growing up, these two twins, Eric and Corey, they were twins, but they weren't identical, but they would fight like motherfuckers. Like, they would beat the shit out of each other on my friend Byron's lawn, and we'd be like, hey, should we stop this? And he's like, nah, let it go. But then I watched Corey unload on another kid at school. And they fought, they got into a fight with like more than one kid, and those two kicked the shit out of like three or four guys.
Oh, really?
Cause they're just like so used to beating the shit out of each other that when they aimed it outward, they just started fucking people up.
A John Woo movie?
Yeah, dude. It was crazy because watching Corey fight, I was like, oh, I'd seen him fight Eric, but you just see him fight his brother and you're like, nah, I don't really know. And then you saw him just tear through a kid and you're like, oh shit.
Was yours a bloody fight, Lou?
Yeah, he kicked my teeth in.
Jesus!
Really?
I mean, it didn't hurt my teeth, but they were all bloody and it was kicking me in the mouth.
Do you call that a Witzky bris?
He kicked you. Well, I was down for the count and he started kicking me. He started kicking me in the mouth.
A Witzky bris.
I'll let that one go.
Kick each other in their teeth.
You're a man now. That's a Witzky bar mitzvah.
A Witzky bar mitzvah. It's a crack cranium.
The bris is, it's a coming of age.
You're now coming of age.
Birthright.
There you go.
God, oh, he kicked your teeth? That's insane.
Fucking crazy. That takes a lot.
This was drunken, yes?
Yeah. That was the last time we fought.
And, but how old were you then?
Oh, 30?
That's embarrassing as hell.
I know. That's why it was the last time.
Was it at his bar?
It was outside of a bar.
Oh, boy. Was there a crowd?
I don't know if I told the story
was it
before.
Over a girl?
It wasn't. Wasn't directly, but he wasn't. I was drunk and I was being an asshole. And we were inside of a bar, and I said, I'm going to fight you. For some reason, I think it was over a girl. I'm like, no, there's no two ways about it. Get outside. I'm going to beat the fuck out of you. So he's like, no, I'm going to be a gentleman and I'm going to avoid this and I'm not doing it. So I said, oh, yeah. I flicked a lit cigarette from point blank range into his cheek, right into his face. Sparks flew off of the side of his cheek.
Yeah.
And he goes, okay, now let's go. Because, like, that was the final straw. So his friend, we get outside, his friend tries to break it up. One punch, I knocked him out cold.
Jesus.
I don't even remember doing it. I don't know how I did it. And then.
You go, because if I could, I would have replicated every time after that.
I don't know how to do, I don't know how, or what I said or whatever. So I'm beating the fuck out of him. I'm winning. I'm on top of him. Punching the shit out of him. And all of a sudden.
While he's unconscious?
No. He's still, I'm just like a Christmas story. Like I'm on top of, I'm Ralphie on top of the.
You're kid. Crying and punching?
Frozen a motherfucker. Did you hear what he's saying?
Yeah.
So then I'm winning and this is really my glory. I'm thinking that this is the first time I'm really going to beat the fuck out of him. And a doorman comes and takes me off of him. Lays me on my back like a fucking turtle and I'm drunk and. that's the position he got me in and started kicking my teeth in, and then he eventually won and threw my sneakers across 8th Avenue as an insult to injury. So
wow.
I'm barefoot, bloody mouth, and walking across.
In Manhattan?
In Manhattan.
To go back to Jersey?
Yeah.
Do you remember where in Manhattan?
8th and 23.
I know. Which bar is that?
It used to be called Wilson's, but now I don't know if it's still a bar.
Oh, okay.
Now it's a twin brothers fighting academy.
Yeah, now it's a fight club for twins to get their aggression out. Do you have someone that looks just like you? Want to kick the shit out of them? Welcome to Lou and
you
Will's.
You want to find out who's the toughest? You two looking like weirdos?
Yeah, welcome to Lou and Will's Fight Academy.
You two split zygotes want to find out?
You guys shared a room. Now you share a planet until this fight academy.
You shared a womb. You shared a room.
Yeah.
Now prepare to share a tomb when the two of you.
Independence comes on 23rd Street. Loser gets his shoes thrown across. I was in a twin brother fights. Loser has his shoes thrown across 8th Avenue match.
He's in a Terry Funk match.
I'm in a twin brother.
A loser has to get his shoes.
I was in a loser has to cross 8th Avenue barefoot and get his shoes.
I like that he kicked your teeth and then took off your shoes and threw them across the
Avenue.
And now, on top of this,
chewing will be a problem. And now your feet are hurt.
Oh, and there was a light drizzle earlier.
Oh, dude,
enjoy having your socks in a light drizzly ground.
You're gonna have slightly wet, musty socks. That's fucking nuts.
Well, that's the lesson. Don't mess with Stu.
Yeah, Stu gets down. How bad was that hangover the next day?
Yeah, pretty bad. Up there.
Were you guys fine in the morning?
Yeah, because we realized that, you know, like Dan said, it's better to work together than against each other. It's like life or death. We're going to kill somebody or ourselves.
So I try to tell Jay with Fugelsang, but he just won't let it go. Wants to kill him. Doesn't want to work with him.
I will fight that guy every day I walk into the studio.
Dude,
506.
How great would it be if we get back from Montreal, we're walking in the studio, and I come in and Jay's just over the trash can, and he goes, yeah, Fugelsang throat chopped him after he heard the show. I didn't know this about Fugelsang. Krav Maga. Pretty good at it.
Go study, yeah.
Studied it in Israel.
Israeli Taekwondo.
He is an Israeli commando. Jay walked in, throat chopped him, kicked him in his back, and said, I would never call you a oinker.
I don't talk like that.
I don't talk.
I don't body shame.
Those aren't my words.
I'm a great person who doesn't body shame.
Because I aggressively fight. Let's get back to this Mr. Pete.
Yeah.
Because it's only a 2-minute video. We're halfway through it.
Those aspects, but I never watch just general scenes and try to critique myself. I just try to be natural and whatever happens, happens, you know?
He seems so
you're
pleasant.
Good or you're not.
He seems so pleasant that it's odd that he keeps saying the aggressive thing.
He is, but it looks like,
he's like a stoner.
If you told me he was like brainwashed by somebody.
Yes. Yes.
Because everybody here has a good time.
Everyone.
We all help each other.
Because we bathe our master when he wants us to.
The nighttime is for sleeping. The hours to be awake are in the light.
Are for working.
Do you want to join the light?
Do you want to see our vegetable garden? We work very hard on it.
Hey, play Christine.
Well, I try to keep two separate lives. You know, I have a family that I have. So when I go home, I'm a father. And
two separate lives.
Yeah, that helps me stay grounded. I've been doing it for a long time as well. I think I made a judgment a couple of years into not care and to hide my porno career. So I've been completely open. So most of the people that know me in my life, other than my kids, because I haven't told them.
Oh, well, I would love to be there for that conversation. Rigo, now, you guys know your dinglings?
It matters if you have sons or daughters, though.
Yeah, daughters, he goes, I am an assassin for the American government. I kill people.
Yeah.
His son, he goes,
I don't want you out there frivolously having sex. So let me show you how daddy does it. So you know you'll never find anyone better.
Jeez, that got dark. That got dark quick. I was going to tell him talking to his sons.
Let daddy have sex with his baby.
Jesus. He goes, I get pretty aggressive when I'm having...
get pretty aggressive with my daughters.
Jesus.
I don't even know if he has daughters. Yeah. We're getting upset about son, if you were making up.
His little son, he goes, do you know how you like to go swimming? Well, that's what daddy does all day in that pussy yeah. up top.
Blah! 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 Daddy knocks out the back like, blah! Blah.
Daddy comes in from the side like this. Blah!
Oh, you daddy be confidently fucking laying it down on black bitches. Blah! Blah!
Blah! Ask your mama why she's so jealous when daddy's at work because he's doing this. One arm push up into the puss.
Contra spray gun. Blah, blah, blah.
I'm coming like this. He's just throwing water in the air. That's what your daddy does.
Dad.
Yeah, he goes, yeah.
Dad, that milk?
Yeah, he goes, no. Oh, jeez. All right, let's hit play.
I want to be a good father and instill good morals.
You know what's funny? When we stop it to do our thing, it does probably read to anyone listening in their cars or trucks right now that we're the bad people, and this guy seems all right.
Yeah. And you know what? I think they do.
Like, you know what? We say things way where he's like, I would never say anything like that about my daughter. I love her very much, but this is how I put her through a very, very elite private school.
He goes, she is at the top of her class in the top school in all of California.
And we're like, what are you, shoving your dick and balls in her butt?
He goes,
that's my daughter, friend.
First off, buddy, I want to tell you this. I'm a huge Fuglesang fan, and I already know about you two.
Dan? I'm aware of your
billboard. I drove by it. No
cool
way.
Billboard. I'm not going to take a set on you, but let me talk to you for a second, Chops.
Yeah. He goes,
Mr. Pete.
Yeah. He goes,
hey, Chops.
Hey, Piglet, get over here. You know who I'm going to fuck? You. Up. Bleep. Bleep. I go, he knows it too. Yeah, he is a very nice guy. He does talk slow like a boxer, but hit for the rest of it, Christine.
Want them to follow in my footsteps, you know. Not that it's the worst thing, but I definitely want a different life for my kids. So
I haven't told them,
but everybody else, it's completely open with family, friends, everybody knows, and
see?
It makes life easier because it's something to talk about always.
Yeah, you go. I guess who'd you fuck? Hey, Pete, what's up? It's your cousin Dan. Who did you fuck today? He goes, hey, not in front of the kid.
Cousin Dan. Hey, how does Tara Patrick suck off? Is she like the best? Yeah.
Could you do it on this mouth? Popsicle?
Happy Hanukkah, by the way.
Yeah, you go, oh, no. Pete, I'm so glad you came to my mom's park July 4th party. July 4th barbecue. Hey, here's a popsicle.
Can you show me?
How does Gianna Michaels just really get down there?
What do you have the Nick Manning? I want to see Nick Manning. He'll make you know.
Wait, I don't think he's done talking. I think he wants to talk about violence in porn movies.
Amber, I live in this world. I don't like violence any more than you do. Violence is a bad thing. But when you see violence in films, it's, you know, if movies, films caused violence, we'd be able to wipe out violence tomorrow. Boom, no more films. That's fine with me. I'll find something else to do. I'll fuck on my own time. You know, I got other interests. I'm a magician. And, you know, hopefully I like, you know, that'll be something that I focus on in the future because you can't fuck forever. I realize that. Anyway, violence is something that plagues us as a society.
Dude, that is, I mean, John C. Reilly, you just knew, like, he's going to be awesome. After seeing him in Boogie Nights, he was, like, easily one of my favorite actors.
Oh, yeah.
Because that scene is so goddamn funny. Boom. No more violence.
I'll fuck on my own time.
Yeah. One of the best parts is one of the deleted scenes where he goes, yeah, you know, Dirk got me into karate.
Shit.
Karate? You're not recording that, are you? Dude, it's so funny. This is Nick Manning, male porn star. So, Mr. Pete, you know what? We tried to shit on him, but he's actually...
He seems like an all right guy.
Yeah.
Can we watch him? I want to see him lay it down. Let me see this guy.
You know
piece.
What? That is appropriate. I mean, if we watch him this interview, we should have to watch him fuck. It's standard. Mm-hmm. It's standard interview policy. For anybody in radio. Nick Manning looks like an evil vampire already.
Yeah, he does not.
The world's hottest porn star. Oh, here he is. Shaved head. Good sneakers. All right, there you go.
Want to see his piece.
Are they fucking the Celine Dion? Her ball, his balls are tiny. Was she an opera singer? He goes, okay, don't move.
Yeah, he's fine. He makes weird faces like he's confused.
He looks like he's frustrated with her. Like, don't move. Don't move. All right. Nope. Kisses.
Oh, yeah. The last thing I got to see always is the batch. I got to see if this guy fires off big or not. He's got a thickie.
He goes, that's good. That's good tile work. His dirty talking's all like just what's happening in the scene. He goes, that's solid. Whoever did that's probably union.
Guys, foot comes. The lamest ones.
Sasha, how are you doing today, darling? Is my audio working well?
Pew. His jizz load was okay.
Yeah.
Nick Manning may impress me more in that realm. But if we can go to Nick Manning. Jeez, we have like 3 minutes left. What the fuck?
No, we don't. We can go longer, right?
Sure.
Okay. Let's go to 45. Fuck it.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck it. Let's do it live.
Fuck it. We'll do it live.
Thing fucking sucks.
I'll write it.
What does that mean?
Take a guess.
Is that your first question is yes. How many words have I won?
Yeah. 10. Does it make a difference to you?
No, I don't know. I probably won like a dozen awards. Okay. Oh, hold on. I didn't know he was coming out the gates being a dickhead. Do you feel like he's got Fuglesang energy, like how towards you? Like that, how he feels towards the interviewer?
I gotta see a little more to know that.
Okay.
I don't know. Right now, I expected this to be not a cool dude.
He's dressed not like a cool guy. He's dressed like a guy that hits on people at airports.
Yeah, purple paisley.
Yeah. He looks like he's like waiting for a flight and he goes, you know, they got spacious bathrooms here.
Yeah. He looks swanky.
Yeah. He looks like he goes to sex parties.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Looks like he sleeps on silk sheets.
We used to sell them on eBay. Really?
Yeah. And I've never won an XRCO award. That sounds made up.
Why is that?
I have no idea. I'm assuming the X-rated critics don't really think that highly of Nick Manning. Third person?
Is this what, 15 years?
Third person is a definite douche fucking alarm. Dan Soder knows that because Dan Soder does it. Dan Soder's impressed that Nick Manning uses third person.
Because I was still modeling and acting in Miami and New York, so I'd fly out here, shoot 4 magazines a week, go home, do Disney commercials. Manning commercials. I was on that TV show The Fugitive, all my children's stuff in between. And then eventually my agent, Irene Marie, found out I was doing adult, and apparently Disney was not very thrilled with me. And it happened after I did the commercial for the California Adventure Park. I was the tour guide on the water ride.
Pause it. That's better for porn. You go watching a porn, you go, I think this is the California Adventure Tour Guide. Fucking the shit out of that lady.
Is that California Adventure Tour Guide? Really ripping into this poor shitter?
Yeah. Is it just me or is this girl getting blasted by the California Adventure Tour Guide? I'm a big commercial guy, and I got to stop this jack to really notice.
Is the men and dude just pile drive fucking this big-titted black chick?
Yeah. Hit play.
First opened. So I get a call one day. This woman screaming in my ear at like 5 a.m. Now, Miami's 3 hours ahead, so it's 8 o'clock there. She gets in the office. You can't go from XXX to G overnight. And so after that, I was like, well, the jig is up. Cat's out of the bag.
It's not the gig is up? All right. You're better than me. He goes, well, actually, you can. He goes, you come on a girl's face, and then you put on a Mickey Mouse costume the next day. It's pretty goddamn easy.
Yeah. It's super simple.
Yeah. I can go XXX to G any day. You know those high-riding shorts where I'm the tour guide?
I mean, you do XXX to G in your life. Probably several times a week.
Everybody does. It's called coming.
Yeah.
That's when you go from XXX to G. You go, I want to watch a movie that makes me sad.
Or like, I'm hungry now. Or
you,
I want to go.
Come and you go, I want to watch Fox and the Hound. Right when you're done blow it alone. I just went XXX to G.
I walked into Vivid's office and I said, well, Let's go. Let's make movies.
First off, pause. He does this thing that I don't like when people do. Yeah. He goes, he's frustrated. He has to explain it. He goes, I walk into Vivid's office. I put my dick on the desk and I go, sign me. Where do I sign?
I go, guess I'm a contract guy.
Yeah.
So I guess I'm not going to be in any more of these ABC commercials. Guess I'm just crushing hot ass. I guess I'm just going to be getting my tits on somebody's
I was waiting for the shut up. Hit play.
This was like on a Tuesday. And back then you could get your test back in a day, right? So they said, okay, we'll shoot you on Friday. They had a movie. PT was doing a film. I walked into Wicked's office because I didn't have an agent. I was just getting direct books. So I walked into Wicked's office, met with Steve Ornstein and Brad, and they had a movie on Thursday called Mirage with Alexa Ray and Sidney Steele.
He remembers the names. And Sidney Steele's hot as shit. Keep going.
Brad's like,
I see you.
Well, whoever I have in this part, I'll kick them out and you be in the movie. And so
and you know who that guy was? Robert Downey Jr. Guess who?
By the way, great screen capture right there.
Fart face.
And then right before I say fart, he goes, take a picture of that. He goes, screenshot.
Forfig Newton.
And next thing I know, I'm fucking this chick, and then I fart.
All right. Oh, Christine's doubling down with taking a picture of a picture. Huh. Of a screen grab.
Yep.
Film. And then as soon as that scene was done, Jeff Hajikani.
That sounds right up.
The PM over there, he came up and gave me 20 other dates. So I was off and running.
Dude, this is like a comic where they go, yeah, and the comic didn't show up, and I went up, and I did a 7-minute set, and I got a standing ovation, and he was like, you're booked for the rest of the year.
It's just easy.
He goes, I walk in, I give a deep dick in, I cash my check. That's what I do.
Play a little more.
How great would it be if it turned out he was one of the Manning brothers?
And he's the other one?
Yeah.
Or didn't make anything of it?
Yeah, Peyton and Eli are like, we stop playing football.
I don't know how to throw a ball, but I sure know how to throw that dick.
He goes, hey, Nick, it's Peyton. Hey, Nick, it's Peyton. Can you stop fucking that pillow? I wanted to go outside and play catch.
I'd love to be there with you, but this fucking pillow can't get it done.
Eli, we gotta go play football. Eli, Nick's busy fucking this bear. I don't know, it's my Dr. Phil, it's my Peyton Manning. Get over it. Big whoop. Want to fight about it?
Back up and tell you the whole story.
All right.
It makes sense to you. Because people ask me this all the time and they think I'm nuts.
You really do? I got to answer the goddamn question. And, you know, I got, next thing, we're back in Los Angeles. 3 hours. I fucked the girl on the thing, and the guy wasn't me. He goes, "Give me your wings." Yeah,
he said, sounded like the fucking equipment coach from Waterboy.
Dang, I was about him,
Miss Boomhauer. Yeah. All right, hit play.
Senior of college, I tore my hamstring in like the fourth game of the year.
Of course,
done. Not drafted. Couldn't play for 2 or 3 years. I mean, literally sat in a chair like this. Couldn't move. I probably should have had some sort of surgery. I didn't have it. I just fucked my way back to
perfect health.
Of course, every time I tried to play, I'd rip it again. So this went on for a while. And finally, I said, well, fuck. I guess I better go do the responsible thing. So I went to grad school. And while I was in grad school, I worked for Life Fitness in the Human Resources Department. That was a division of Valley's, made all the equipment. I was in Chicago, and then I worked at this other company.
Let me see this guy come.
Yeah, I'm over him talking. We gotta get out of here. Whoa, he's got his dick. Oh, she's got her pussy boobs. Boom.
All right, he's got a good piece, not a majorly impressive piece.
There he goes,
and
laser noise.
Oh, but the thing is, that's the big thing we learn on Stern. He yells out, dropping loads when he comes.
Do we have audio, Christine?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's his big thing. He yells the words, dropping loads.
I like fucking that mop.
Oh, okay,
this girl looks so bored.
Yeah. She looks like she's... Yeah. She looks like she's trying to swallow...
I'm gonna come in your fucking mop. Yeah, yeah, oh, yeah. Dropping fucking loads. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I didn't even tell you. Yeah. Of course. Yeah. He laughs while he's talking.
Oh, my God, that is fucking...
Guy's got a good dick, good load.
He goes like this. Dropping, I'm dropping. I'm dropping. So, is he the first male porn star with a catchphrase?
When they come? Yeah, I think Lexington Steel just screams.
I'd go like this. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. That would be my come noise. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy.
Well, I think we blew the load on this episode. I think we just popped. It's time to go from X-rated back to our G-lives.
I'm going to go get a Cliff Bar and an iced coffee.
Let's go get some of that Saturday Night Beaver.
I hope you guys...
Don't dance. I don't dance on Sundays.
I hope you campers enjoyed the lost tapes this week. Another very, very fun week of doing it.
Next week, we'll be in Montreal at the Just for Laughs Comedy Festival. So if you're a fan, make sure you email us at thebonfire@siriusxm.com.
The Bonfire SXM, I think,
the,
right?
TheBonfireSXM@gmail.com. Send to the email address.
Everything was wrong.
Everything was all about that was wrong. But we will be live from 6 to 8 p.m. for the 2-year anniversary show at the Soprano C Room at the Hyatt Regency Hotel. So it's a free show. So if you can make it out to the show and you like tickets, email us at TheBonfireSXM@gmail.com. And, of course, if you're at Just for Laughs, go check out Big J Oakerson. He's going to be on the Nasty Show July 19th through the 29th. And also 5 What's Your Fucking Deals. All crowdwork shows, so go get tickets at BigJComedy.com.
And, of course, Dan Soder's new half-hour special, The Stand-Ups, as part of The Stand-Ups, is available now on Netflix. And also he's going to be at the D.C. Draft House Thursday, July 20th through Saturday, July 22nd.
Dropping loads!
Dropping loads to get your tickets for Dan's shows that I just announced and all of his shows. Why was that so discombobulated? At DanSoder.com, everybody. We'll catch y'all motherfuckers next week. Crackle, crackle.
Bye.
You know, I mean, I'm Dirk Diggler. Brock Landers is a character that I'm playing. I'm going to ask you once more, and I'm going to ask you nice. Where the fuck is Ringo, you bitch?
Fuck you.